Today in this video, we will discuss about what is meant by conservative force and non-conservative force and which are the properties of conservative force. Okay, so we will start with conservative force. When the work done by the force is independent of the path, when work done by the force, for what purpose work done by the force in displacing, we can write in displacing. Depends only on the initial and final positions. So, a force is said to be conservative force when the work done by the force. What purpose that work is done? For displacing an object from one position to another, depends only on the positions and independent of the path. That force is known as conservative force. Okay, so an object we are taking from position A to position B. Okay, a conservative force is active. So if we are taking that object to this path, this part we can mark it as part 1. So some part will be done. Okay. And if the same object we are taking to another part, like this part, we are taking that object, one object we are taking from position A to position B, and if the force acting is conservative force, for that object we take them from A to B. So if the work done, but for taking the object to path 1 and through path will be, path 2 will be same. Why it is so? Because it depends only on initial and final position. What is the initial position? Initial position is A. Which is the final position? Final position is B. So whichever path we have to see, it is not a matter because it is independent of the path. It does not depend on the path. Through which path that object is taken, but it depends only on the initial and final positions. Such forces are said to be conservative forces. Okay, is it clear? So force is said to be conservative if the work done by the force for displacing an object from one position to another depends only on the initial and final positions and does not depend on the path. So whether we are choosing a path like this or whether we are choosing a path like this, so in all these parts, we can say that one gun will be, one gun is same for all the parts. One gun is same for all the parts. Okay. Whichever part is followed, not a matter. Since the only conservative forces are acting, so one gun by the conservative force does not depend on the path and depends only on the initial and final position. Such forces are said to be conservative forces. Okay? Is it clear? So, now if we are considering the case, an object is there, A, conservative, an object is there of mass, and mass is there. Okay? And conservative force is acting on the object because of which it is displaced to B. Again, the same conservative force is acting because of which it is coming from B. So what will be the work done? Work done depends only on initial and final position. Which is the initial position? A. It is taken to B, again it is coming back to A. So we can write work done for a closed path is equal to work done for a closed path is zero. What is the condition? Force should be conserved. Why? Because through this path, in that case, we can write WAB, work done. So if we are considering it as positive, in opposite, it will be negative. But then to bring that object from B to A is negative. So total work done is equal to force. Magnitude will be same since it is sides are different. So total work done we can write it as zero. Okay. So we can say that only if only conservative force is acting, if force is conservative, work done for a closed path is zero. Or otherwise, very easily we can say for a closed path, what is the initial position? Initial position is A. Which is the final position? Final position is again A. So what is the total work done? Is A. Okay? Is it clear? So work done for a closed path will be zero if conservative force is zero. So the best example of conservative, various examples are there. One of the example of conservative force is gravitational force. Example of conservative force is gravitational force. Gravitational force is an example of conservative force. Is it true? Shall we check? So an object is there. It is on the ground level. So we are taking that object to this height h. So object should be taken to this height h. The same object we are taking from this level to this. So we can take one part like this and another part. What we are doing is that we are taking that object horizontally, then moves vertically, again moves horizontally, again moves. Another part we are choosing like this. Okay. So this is first part, this is second. So here, if we are considering the first part, we can say work done directly, we can write work done is equal to mgh. So for the second part, again work done we can write it as mgh. Why? Because work done through these horizontal parts, this horizontal and this horizontal part, work done is zero. Because weight is acting vertically downwards and displacement here, displacement is in this direction, so the angle between weight and displacement is 90 degree. So again, in this case, what happens? Work done is zero, and for this also work done is zero. So total work done we will get only from these three parts. So that also will be again, so work done by part one is mgh. Again, we can write work done through part 2, that is also mgh. So here we can say that this work done by gravitational force depends only on which is the initial position and which is the final. This is an example of conservatism. Similarly, if the object is started from ground and finally it is coming back to the ground level, what is the net displacement? Net displacement is 0, h is 0, so work done will be 0. So we can say that one of the examples of conservative force is gravitational force. Various other examples are there in the same chapter. Next topic that we will study, the force acting on a spring, that is another example of conservative force. And in next year we will study about electrostatic force, it is, or Coulomb force, that is another example of conservative force. So a force is said to be conservative if the work done by the force depends only on the initial and final positions and does not depend on the path. Okay? Or in other words, we can say that work done by conservative force for a closed path or a closed trip will be zero. Okay? Now we will discuss the properties of conservative. Which are the properties of conservative? Properties of conservative forces. Okay. So first two properties that we are telling from the definition itself, we are arriving at conclusion from the definition itself directly. So we can write the work done by the conservative force. Yes. The work done by the conservative force. Work done by the conservative force for a closed path is zero, or closed trip is zero. Okay? Because the initial and final positions are the same, so work done will be zero. And third property. Minus d by dx means it is the derivative, and U means potential energy. So we can say that potential energy will be a function of position, and if you differentiate that with respect to position, we will get the force. Okay, so conservative force can be obtained as minus dx by dx. So shall we check whether it is true for gravitational force? So we are considering an object. Object is at a height x from the ground. Okay, so we can write its potential energy and mass of the object be m. M is the mass of the object. So its potential energy we can write it as mgs. So potential energy is given by mgs. Now we can check whether it is true or not. So we can write F. The force acting is given by minus d by dx of mgs. Mass and acceleration due to gravity does not vary with position. We can take outside. So minus mg into d by dx of x. So if you differentiate x with respect to x, what you will get? You will get it as 1. So this is minus. So the force is given by minus mg, that is a gravitational force acting on the object. So we can see that gravitational force is equal to minus du by dx if only conservative force is acting. So how we are getting this relation? This you may remember that d by dx of, in the previous videos we discussed, d by dx of x raised to n is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1 into x raised to then minus 1. So here what we are writing, d by dx of x is equal to x raised to 1, we can write, no? 1 into x raised to 1 minus 1. So 1 into x raised to 0, that will be written as 1. So 1 into mg, it will be written as mg, and minus sign already is there. And what is negative sign shows? Negative sign shows that the gravitational force is acting opposite to the direction of displacement. Okay, is it clear? So the third property we can say that if only conservative force is acting, this conservative force can be written as minus du by dx. Okay. What is u? U is the potential energy, and x is the displacement or position variation issue. Is it clear? And now we will discuss the fourth property. Okay. If only conservative forces are acting, the total mechanical energy remains constant. Only conservative forces are acting, the total mechanical energy remains constant. So what is meant by mechanical energy? Mechanical energy means it is a sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So kinetic energy plus potential energy will remain constant. So that we have to check whether it is true or not. Okay. So we know the relation between work energy theorem. We know that work energy theorem, but that is equal to change in kinetic. So we can write from work energy theorem, from work energy theorem, we can write work done is equal to W is equal to F delta X, which is equal to change in time. F delta X, delta W, if we are writing delta W is equal to F delta A, which is equal to delta K. What is that delta K? Change in kinetic energy. Now, from the third property we can write. From the third property of conservative force, what we know, F is equal to minus delta U by delta X, du by dx. What delta stands for? Delta stands for small. Very, that will be very small variation of some quantity, we are writing it as delta. Okay. So minus delta u by delta x. Fourth, we can write delta u is equal to minus f delta x. Okay. So first one we put f delta x. F delta x is equal to delta k. And minus f delta x is equal to delta k. So we are adding what we will do. If we add 1 and 2, 0 is equal to delta k plus delta u. Delta k means changing kinetic energy, delta u means changing potential energy is equal to 0. Both we can write total changing kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to 0. Where k stands for kinetic energy, u stands for potential energy. So, change in total, sum of kinetic energy and potential energy is change. Delta means radiation will be 0. Both we can write k plus u is equal to constant. What is k plus u? K plus u is the total mechanical energy, sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So we can write kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to constant. Okay. So these are the four properties of conservative forces. And now we will discuss about non-conservative forces. Non-conservative forces. So we know the property of conservative force, that is work done by the conservative force depends only on the initial and final position, does not depend on the mass. So here what we have to write, the work done by non-conservative force depends on the mass. Okay. So a force is said to be non-conservative force. If the work done by the force depends on the path. If the work done by the force depends on the path, it does not, whichever path it is taken accordingly, that work done will be made. If it is a smaller part, work done will be small. If it is a larger part, work done will be larger. Okay. So, for example, if an object is taken from A to B, so if it is taken like this, if it is non-conservative force is acting through this part, work done will be the least. And if it is taken like this, longer part, so work done will be more. Same, initial and final positions are even though same. Work done will be more in second part than in first part. Why? Because here more part has to travel. Okay? And it depends on the path. Such force is known as non-conservative force. Examples are frictional force and viscous force. These are examples of non-conservative force. Frictional force will be always act against the motion of the object. Similarly, viscous force means it is the opposing force acting on an object when the object is moving in a fluid. Either in liquid or gas, the opposing force comes into play, is known as viscous force. So, the work done by either frictional force or viscous force does not depend on the initial and final position. It always depends on the path. So, these are the best examples for non-conservative forces. Okay. So, you clearly understood the difference between conservative and non-conservative forces. And now we will discuss about law of conservation of mechanical energy for a freely falling object. Law of conservation of energy. For a freely falling object. So, when an object is falling only under gravity, we can say that its the object's total mechanical energy remains constant. That is known as law of conservation of mechanical energy. But it says an object when it falls under gravity, its total mechanical energy remains constant. At any instant of time, in each and every point, the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy will remain same. Okay, that we are going to discuss how we can prove that the total mechanical energy is constant. That we are going to discuss now. For that, we are considering an object. Let it be initially at a height h from the ground, and let we can mark that position as A. Okay. Initially, object is at a position A, which is at a height h from the ground. From that position, we are dropping that object. So when we are dropping that object, what happens to its initial velocity? We are dropping. So just before dropping its initial velocity, we can take it as zero. So initial velocity is equal to zero. Now that object is coming downwards. So at some instant, let the object be at position B, which is at a distance x. Or we can say that it is displaced from A to B, having a displacement x. So what will be the position of B from the ground level? It will be h minus x. Finally, it reaches the position C, that is the ground level. Okay, is it clear? So these are the three different positions. Okay, finally it is reaching the position C. So A, B, C, these positions. So we have to show that at position A we have to find kinetic energy and potential energy. Similarly, at position B we can find kinetic energy and potential energy, and at position C also we can find kinetic energy and potential energy, and their sums are equal, that we have to show. So first of all, let's start with position. So here we can mark, we can write one more thing. What is the mass of the object? Mass of the object is equal to, mass of the object is m, and acceleration due to gravity is g. Due to gravity is g. And let vv and vc are the velocities of the object when it reaches the position b and c. Okay. So we start with position A. At position A, what is the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is equal to, formula is given by half m v square. Here velocity, initially object is at rest, so we can write kinetic energy is equal to zero by initial velocity is zero. Now what is the potential energy? Potential energy can be written as mgh. The object is at a height h from the ground level, so we can write it is equal to mgh. So mechanical energy is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy, so that is equal to 0 plus mgh. So we can write total mechanical energy is equal to mgh. Okay, so when it is at the position A, total mechanical energy, we will get as mgh. Now we have to check whether when it reaches the position B also total mechanical energy is mgh. Okay, so now we will see the case at position B. When it is at the position B. Okay. So what is the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy, we can write it as half into mass into velocity at that instant. What is the velocity? Velocity is v. Okay, half into m into v square. What is vv? Here we can write vv and vc. Velocity is of the object. H, B and C respectively. Okay, BB and BC are the velocities of the object at B and C respectively. Kinetic energy is given by half mv. And what is the potential energy? Potential energy can be written as mg into height from the ground level. What is the height from the ground level? It is h minus. Now what is the total energy? Total energy, mechanical energy is equal to ke plus pe. Ke plus pe, kinetic energy plus potential energy. So half m dv square plus mg into h. Whether they are equal to mgh? Yes, they are equal to. If you add both of them, you will get mgh. How? We can substitute from second equation of motion. The third equation, it is v square equal to v square equal to u square plus 2ax. We know that equation. V square equal to u square plus 2ax. Here object is coming from A to B. What is initial velocity? Initial velocity is 0. When it reaches the position B, what is the velocity of the object at that instant? That is v. So we can write vb square equal to 0 plus 2. Acceleration is acceleration due to gravity. And what is the displacement? It is x. So vb square equal to, what do you get? Then we can substitute here. What do you get? Mechanical energy is equal to half m into 2gx plus mg into h minus x. What do you got? Mgx plus mgh minus mgx. Again, we go total mechanical energy is equal to mgh. So at position B also, we go total mechanical energy is equal to mgh. Now, the third case, when it reaches the position C, at position C, that object is coming from A to C. Okay, A to C. Initially, object is at A and finally it is reaching to C. So, what is the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy can be written as half m u vc square, where vc is the velocity. And what is the potential energy? Potential energy is equal to 0 because it is at the ground level. So, total mechanical energy we can write. What is the total mechanical energy? Sum of kinetic energy plus potential energy. Kinetic energy, potential energy is 0. So we can write total mechanical energy is equal to half m vc square. Again, we can show that that is equal to mgh. So from the same equation, we can see v square equal to u square plus 2ax. Here final velocity is e. It is starting from A and finally it is reaching to C. Okay. So initial velocity is 0 plus 2g. And what is the displacement? Started from A and it reached to C. The displacement is given by h. So we want bc square equal to 2gh. So that you can substitute here. So you got total mechanical energy is equal to half m into bc square, half m into 2gh. So here also you got total mechanical energy is equal to 2gh. So we can say that when an object is falling under gravity at any instant of time, total mechanical energy remains same. Then what makes the difference? Only one thing it makes the difference is that the form of energy will be different. When it is at the maximum height, you can see that total energy is purely potential. The total energy is completely potential energy, kinetic energy is zero. And when it reaches the ground level, you can see that total mechanical energy is purely kinetic, its potential energy is zero. But in between this maximum height and ground level, the energy will be sum of kinetic and potential energy. Okay, it will be the sum of kinetic and potential energy. And when it is at the maximum height, the total mechanical energy will be purely potential. When it is at the ground level, total mechanical energy will be purely kinetic, and in between it will be sum of kinetic and potential energy. But it doesn't matter, total mechanical energy will always remain same, that we have shown. Okay, and that statement is known as law of conservation of mechanical energy for a freely falling object. That is, the total mechanical energy of a freely falling object remains constant throughout its motion. Okay, that is known as law of conservation of energy, mechanical energy. Why mechanical energy remains constant? Because here gravitational force is a conservative force. Since conservative force is acting, we know the property of conservative force, its total mechanical energy remains constant. And when it touches the ground level, what happens? When it touches the ground level, that energy will be, this mechanical energy will be converted into sound energy or heat energy and so on. Okay, and if it bounces back, if a board we are dropping from top to ground, what happens? It may bounce back, no? But sometimes very rarely that it will reach the same point. Okay, because some energy will be released. Is it clear? So this is what is meant by law of conservation of mechanical energy. The total mechanical energy of a freely falling object remains constant. But the form may change. Either it may be kinetic or purely potential, or purely kinetic or some of kinetic and potential. But total mechanical energy will be always constant. Okay. So if you are plotting a graph between, here we can write kinetic energy we are plotting, potential energy also we are plotting, total mechanical energy also we are plotting with height, with position. With height. So we can say that potential energy increases, no? As height increases, potential energy increases. But in the case of kinetic energy, what happens? As height increases, kinetic energy increases. Kinetic energy is the maximum at the ground level, and as height increases, its kinetic energy, the kinetic energy of the object will be gradually decreasing because gravity is acting downward. And this we can show that this is the total energy. So we can write this is the mechanical energy. Here you see mechanical energy, and this stands for kinetic energy, and this stands for potential energy. So potential energy will be increased. When it is starting from position ground level to height, potential energy will be increased, mgh, no? So if h increases, potential energy increases. But here in the case of kinetic energy will be maximum at the ground level, and as height increases, its kinetic energy gradually increases. And if you are finding the total mechanical energy, what happens? Total mechanical energy remains constant. So at the ground level it will be purely kinetic. And at the maximum height, it will be purely potential. In between, it will be sum of kinetic and potential. Is it clear? Okay. So today we discussed about conservative forces, non-conservative forces, and their properties, examples, and law of conservation of mechanical energy. I hope all of you understood. If you are having any doubt, feel free to ask. Thank you.